Hello, today is a great day for America. Thank you for taking a walk with us into a world of miracles. In this series of meditations, we explore the spectacular incidents that took place during the life and times of Jesus Christ. These we call miracles. I am Reverend Ronald Nathan, and I'm the minister at the Hogard Amy Zion Church in Jackson, in the parish of St. Michael, in the Republic of Barbados. A miracle is an extraordinary and astonishing happening that is due to the presence and actions of God. The miracles of Jesus Christ gives us a glimpse into his compassion, his identity, and of his future plans, which culminates in our exclamation, "Oh my God." These "Oh my God" moments, these miracles that we have been exploring, testify to the power of God in our world. Today, we explore Jesus' cleansing of the 10 lepers found in Luke, the 17th chapter, verse 11 to 19. Now, on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. As he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." When he saw them, he said, "Go show yourself to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw he was healed, came back praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him, as he was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, "Were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this stranger?" Then he said to him, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well." Strange bedfellows. Sickness threw them together. Sickness threw them together. We don't know how long these men traversed the rugged hills of Judea and the semi-arid grasslands of Samaria. What we do know is that they all found themselves in the same condition. They had leprosy. They were all ostracized from normal human living. Someone once said, "Birds of a feather flock together." So they found company, compassion, and community around their common malady. They knew they were dependent on each other's support, as the pickings were few for these outcasts of the first century Jewish society. They looked out for each other. They ate together and they slept together. They would have opportunity to discuss life and how society had treated with them. Some would be bitter, some melancholy, and some nonchalant. The routine of their pathetic lives was disturbed by the news that Jesus, the reputed healer and Messiah from Nazareth, was coming towards a village on the border of Samaria and Galilee. Whether intentionally or by happenstance, they found themselves in the vicinity of the passing Palestinian, the deliverer. And by consensus, they became a choir of desperation. In unison, with a loud voice, they cried out, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." Jesus heard them and spoke healing in their direction and sent them off to be certified, cleansed. However, we are told that although sickness had thrown them together, healing and wholeness now had separated them. The people in a crowd do not always have to be of the same mind. one man, a Samaritan, an outsider among the outcasts, understood that it is polite to say thanks to those who assisted you, especially when they did not have to. He was a foreigner from the Commonwealth of Israel, and a stranger to the promised land, but a friend of the grateful, turns back to see the one who had helped him in his double jeopardy. For he had been a leper and was a Samaritan, a foreigner. He loudly gave thanks and praise to Jesus, falling at his feet with gratitude, and got an additional blessing. He moved from having received a miraculous touch of God to being full of faith in God and God's power. So Jesus' words to him was, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well." God the Father is seen here working the extraordinary through his Son for his praise, glory, and honor. That's what a miracle is about. And today, God wants to be praised, glorified, and honored in your own situations. For that is where miracles begin, when you believe him to show up, show forth, and show off. May God bless you, and have a great day.